Antibodies are proteins that are made in the blood in response to an encounter with a bacterium or a virus, a pathogen, something that's going to cause us illness. Those antibodies don't necessarily help us greatly in the first encounter, but the second time we encounter the bug, we're now protected. And that's why we don't get the same infection twice. And that's the basis of vaccines, because vaccines trick the body into making antibodies against the bug without even seeing the bug. So when the bug comes, we're equipped to take care of it. So we're interested in finding those antibodies to coronavirus, making them, perhaps using them as therapeutics themselves, but using them also to help us to make vaccines that will protect against the coronavirus.
One of the most interesting parts of our research is a close collaboration with COVID-positive patients who are willing to participate in clinical trials for examining immune responses directly from bench to bedside and back again. And so right now we're examining what are the B-cell responses and antibody responses that we are observing, and how can that be translated into quick interventions for the community. We now have identified monoclonal antibodies that already appear to bind to the virus, and now we're testing them. Are they useful in preventing infection? And can we make them rapidly for any interventions that we'll need?
We are seeing antibodies that recognize or react with SARS, the first coronavirus that really caused a lot of problems, also react with the new coronavirus. So that's very encouraging, because it means that antibodies against one might protect against the other. Neutralizing antibodies are those that work very well in terms of protection. For example, against a virus, they stick to the virus and get rid of it. So neutralizing. Broadly neutralizing antibodies are those antibodies that react or take care of many different viruses of a certain type. So, for example, with coronavirus, if the antibody was able to take care of SARS, this current coronavirus, and another coronavirus, MERS, we would call them broadly neutralizing, because they're hitting all of those viruses. So we're looking for broadly neutralizing antibodies and pan-coronavirus vaccines across all the coronaviruses. We don't know how feasible that is yet, but that seems to be the way to go.
I think we're in desperate need for a preventative or therapeutic drug or small molecule. And I think understanding how our own bodies are generating antibodies against active infection is a very rapid path towards an intervention. One could imagine a monoclonal antibody that is highly neutralizing to the virus could be rapidly deployed for either a preventative or a therapeutic. Secondly, it's critically important that we rapidly screen known drugs for their ability to prevent infection or to prevent diseases associated with infection. So I think our highest priorities are, can we examine the immune response and study it well? And can we screen known drug libraries for medications that can be turned into interventions?